After that, sometimes in this foreign land also, in Los Angeles, and preach there very nicely together, dancing, chanting, you know. So, I'm so much delighted to see him here. Astonishing. It is very delighting to me. The thing is that Krishna, this in short form of lecture, this I will present it to you. We are from Bhakti Siddhanta of Saraswati's family. And it was marvelous to think of, that our previous brother, like very friendly to us also, his divine is from Bhakti Siddhanta of Swami Maharaj, widely known as Prabhupada. He lived with me there in Vrindavan, in some rented home. Nothing, no what was there, this Chaitanya Gaudiya there. And that Swami Maharaj, revered Pujyapada Swami Maharaj, and his divine grace was Keshav Goswamiji Maharaj, in that role, our Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Maharaj has come. I saw him when he took sannyas at that period. My Guru Maharaj, Madhava Goswami Maharaj, his divine grace was there in Guwahati, in Dr. Chatterjee's home. He and Vaman Maharaj, revered Vaman Maharaj, they came both there. As he and that, you know, we are this contemporary of the same age. So, that time I first saw him, both Vaman Maharaj and him. Now, it is very likely that all the time he is improving in his preaching. He is now second form of Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj now. He is so kind to preach all over the world with the Swami Maharaj disciples, you know. He is not no other than Swami Maharaj and his scholar Gaudiya. We belong to the same family. We'll be thinking, very delighted to think that we are of the same family and we are trying to get all with one family by Harinam Sankirtan. The whole world, we want to grasp the whole world, the whole Brahmandas, even Brahmandas, even. Krishna includes everything. So we chant Harinam Sankirtan. We also, following his divine footsteps, Krishna's, we want to get both Brahmandas in our family. All over the world we shall be teaching. All over the Brahmand we shall be teaching. Our Guru Narada Goswami preached all over, you know, all the time. So in brief, he gave me 10 minutes to speak. Apparently, what this perceptive words are here, sensitive words, as we touch from our eyes, from our ears, from our mouth, from our eyes, we touch this material world. This is material world. That is under misery competent, you know. So that is in Sanskrit called prayo. Apata manalam, ultimately that will give some truth, some pain should be there, arising. Inevitable, pains are inevitable in this material world. And here, only the jiva souls, you know, crawling for death all the time. Sarvata mrityu upasa mahalukkamani. So, we want to cross over this material world because we are averse to God. Being averse to God, we are suffering in this material world. So it is very nice to think of that those who are under Gauriya Math, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's footsteps, they are rectifying, they are purifying the whole world. Amongst them, Narada Maharaj also purifying us, realize that what to show the humble one, the layman, you can say. So it is supreme kind of donation, that is supreme kind of blessings, supreme kind of friendliness is dispersing, he is dispersing, he is distributing to all. But Jiva Sakha, he is the Sakha, he is the confident friend, bosom friend to all. So may Lord, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, and his all the Gosti, all the family, Asar blessings upon him, so that he will gradually try to continue preaching, because our age is now gone. We have to according to date now, 83 now. He also mostly maybe 2-3 years, maybe bigger, I mean the senior. Okay, so he sometimes told me that, no Maharaj, you are senior to me. Now, today he is saying that he is 88 now. I am 83. So we shall be calling today, but you the disciples of our Gauriya Math, it is my proud privilege to think of, you all are the Gauriya Math disciples. Not this one except otherwise. All Gauriya Math disciples of the same family, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. So we shall be getting together and teaching very nicely. I am so long we shall be living in this material body. Because the Harinam will talk to us, Sri Vikra will talk to us, and in the sorrow, in the real form of existence of the Lord, that Nam Vikra Sarup in Atiru, in Chidanand Guru. So he is waiting for us he is waiting for us. It is in Dvaita Dharma also, that he is all the time waiting to us, because we surrender our this sadhinata, that we feed a free will at this lotus feet. We should not misuse sadhinata, we should not misuse free will according to our own way for my enjoyment, but for the pleasure of the Lord, we should place our sadhinata, his free will, at the lotus feet of the Lord, and we will receive all kinds of sampratis, all kinds of opulences, all kinds of praise of the Lord at the lotus feet of the Lord Krishna, Guru Krishna, and we shall be distributing them to all of the Brahmandas, not only this material world, universe. So we are all the time praying to the Lord, so may our dear Narayan Maharaj progressing in his last stage, progressing more and more. Thank you very much. Very, very kind of you that you all are assisting him. I am very much grateful to you all. Thank you.
Om Jnana Simirandasya Jnanam Janasavataya Chaksuram Nitham Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. First I offer my unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipable Diksha Gurudev, Nityananda Pravishta Om Vishnupada, Astotanasthita Sri Srima Chila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. And the same unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipful Shiksha Gurudev, Om Vishnu Pad Astotanasthita Sri Srima Chila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. To all of our disciplic succession and all the assembled devotees. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to speak a few words of introduction. The introduction to our coming here tonight is as follows. Brahmanda Bhumite Konya Bhagya Vanaji Guru Krishna Prashade Pai Bhakti Lati Beach. We've been wandering throughout many, many millions of universes in 8,400,000 species of life and suffering throughout hellish planets, trying to enjoy in heavenly planets, just like a roller coaster, up and down, under the strict control of Maya. But here and there, through various lives, we have performed what's been called Sukriti, or spiritual pious activities. Unknown and known spiritual pious activities. And thus, we got sanskars, or impressions on our hearts, over many, many lives. And what is the result? Bhakti stu bhagavata bhakti, Sangena parijayate, satsanga labhyate punbir, sukritaya purva sanskritaya. After many, many millions of births throughout different species of performing spiritual pious activities and getting sufficient impressions, good impressions on the heart, one meets a bona fide devotee manifestation of Sri Krishna himself in the form of a bhakta, a pure devotee. And by the association of the pure devotee, one gets bhakti. What is bhakti? Whatever we do, whatever we think, whatever we speak, whatever we offer or give away, is simply for the pleasure of Krishna. And the highest examples of bhakti are in Goloka Vrindavan. Krishna's parents, his friends, his beloved gopis. So Sri Guru came from that realm to bring us to that realm. And what is the process? Satam prasangam mama virya samvido bhavanti ritukarna rasayana kata tajjoshana jaswapavarga vadmani Shadav Bhagavatir Bhaktir Anukramishyati. Lord Krishna himself, in the form of Lord Kapila, gives the process. By associating with my pure devotees, who are my own associates, who've come from that realm, the spiritual world, in order, as Sri Padmanga Maharaj mentioned, who comes here to get all the buds of flowers, or seeds of flowers, or wilted flowers of souls, to make us blossom and become offerable. And then he offers us to Radha and Krishna in the spiritual world. So that sut, that eternal associate of the Lord, Lord himself says, in association with that caliber of devotee, those who hear about my glorious activities, they become purified. First, that transcendental sound vibration, that Shabda Brahman, comes from his glands. The praying atoms come from the portholes of his body. And from his lotus mouth comes the transcendental sound vibration that carries the aroma of the saffron dust particles of Krishna's lotus feet. It enters into the ears and satisfies both the ears and the heart. And tajjoshanat asva pavarga vartmani, one proceeds straight path of liberation from pavarga, pavabhagama, the material situation of great hard labor, just like a horse is laboring so hard that it's foaming at the mouth. And for what? For death and then going down again to the lower species of life. Chewing the chew that our relatives are in, our ancestors have chewed. One chews bubble gum, throws it on the floor, it mixes with all the dirt in the street, and then the next person picks it up and chews the same thing. Punar punar chagri puchagri nana. Chewing the same already chewed. So hearing from the pure devotee the beautiful, glorious pastimes and qualities of the Lord, one proceeds straight on the path of liberation and goes from shraddha, faith, that if I just serve Krishna, all my other activities, all my other goals of life are taken care of. Going from shraddha to anarjana vritti, being freed from all unwanted habits and thoughts. Going to steadiness, to pure taste, to attachment from the Lord, just like a lover has a spontaneous attachment to another lover. It's no duty, it's just natural. So one comes to the platform of natural attachment to the Lord, and then ecstasy, transcendental, ecstatic moods towards the Lord, and finally praying, Shraddha, Ratir, Bhaktir, Anupramishati, step by step in that divine association. So now, after so many births, we have that great association. We had Srila Prabhupada, and by His mercy, He's brought us also to Srila Gurudev's lotus feet, where we can have His lotus feet, Prabhupada's lotus feet, and the lotus feet of all of our Guru Parampara in their association in the spiritual world. Thank you.
First of all, I pay my humble obeisances to the lotus feet of my Paramahansa Prabhupada, Om Vishnupada, Astotara Satvasa Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Goswami Maharaj, and Om Vishnupada, Parikajakacharya Varja, Astotara Satvasa Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Goswami Maharaj. I pay my obeisances to the lotus feet of my spiritual grandsire, Nitya Lila Prasad Vishnupada, Sri Bhakti Kalyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, and Nitya Lila Prasad Vishnupada, Sri Bhakti Kalyan Swami Maharaj, in the obeisances of Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, and guests assembled here, headed by Parampuja Bhakti Sri Bhakti Lila Mangal Maharaj. Sri Gurudev ordered me to speak some Harikatha. Since before you have heard from our previous speaker, we have heard from Sri Gurudev, and it is true, in this world, all are seeking for happiness and trying for happiness. No one wants any unhappiness. For this reason, the science has discovered so many things. Today you can see the transportation, communication, medical science, how much they developed. If you go to 100 years back, nothing was there. And nowadays, so develop. Why? They want more and more happiness. Are they happy at all? If you go 100 years back, each other gets some love and affection. Nowadays, love and affection go far away from us. As before, we know each other. But nowadays, we don't know who are our next neighbors in our next flat. We don't know at all. So what is the result of improvement of science? They take our love and affection from each other. If you want to be really happy, then what is the process? have the thought that nityati dena vittena durlabhena atma mrityuna kriyapatta pasubhika apri salitasya loi. We are hankering for money. And is money give us eternal happiness? If you have much more money, you have much more anxiety. And we are thinking, money is money sweeter than honey and brighter than sunshine. It is not true at all. So this money will not give you eternal happiness. What you incoming or earning by money, this is a cause of your anxiety, not eternal happiness. If you earn much more dollar, you will not need dollar. What you are spending foodstuff every day, you have to do same thing. So why we are working so hard like a junkie? Even when we give up this body, even if you take with us a clip of hair, what to say about which are in this world? If you really want to be happy, then what is the process? Prahlad Maharaj told to all the world that Kaumara Achavet Prakko Dharmayan Bhagavatanya Durdhava Manasa Dhyana Padam Padhuva Mahapadam. He has to practice bhakti yoga from teenage, from childhood. Then he can advance in Krishna consciousness or be eternally happy. Why not? If we do bhajan knowledge, Prabhu Maharaj told to us that in this world, if we think our average age is 100 years, then we work in daytime and sleep at night, special weekend and sleep too much, almost 50% is spending in sleeping, and left over 50%, 50 years. The old age, 80 to 100 years, at that time, we could not walk without any help of stick. And there were so many diseases attack us. And at that time, we want to speak something, we further want to speak. Devotee is telling, Krishna Todya Parada Pankaja Panya Rankam, Matai Bhavishatu Manasa Raja Hamsa, Prana Prana Samaya Kamabhata Kitkari, Kanta Vardhanam Yudhavu Bhajanam Kitaske. If you want to do bhajan in old age, not possible at all. At that time, you are neglected by your families, have to be in old house, no one is there to give you love and affection, and you want to speak, we first will chop your voice. So devotees are asking to Krishna, oh Krishna, please allow me to be a bhajan from my childhood. So 50 years by sleeping, and 80 to 100 years only. So 50 plus 20, 70 years. 30 years remain there. If you want to be an expert, to income money, you need about 20 years. So, 50 plus 20 plus 20 is 90. Only left about 10 years. Among these, oh, I have to marry, I have my girlfriend, boyfriend, I have to manage my material world, there is time to do bhajan. So, do bhajan in beginning time. If you do bhajan in childhood time, from childhood, then gradually, some impression will come in your mind. Then your mind will not be disturbed. You can earn your money, you can do your job or business, send them to bhajan, then you can be happy. And how to do bhajan? And Prabhu Maharaj told, Guru Susu Saya Bhakta, Sarva Adhar Panayacha, Sangya Sadhu Bhaktanam, Ishtara Radha Nayacha. If you want to do bhajan, if you want to do bhajan direct, it is not possible. Prabhu Maharaj instructing us, Guru Susu Saya Bhakta, we have to serve your Gurudev with great honor. And which you possess, have to offer to Srila Gurudev. Which here, your mind, uncontrolled mind, have to offer to Gurudev. And which you possess in this world, we are the owner of this, and everything to donate to Gurudev. Then how we maintain my life? If you donate Gurudev, then Krishna will take care totally. And Gurudev will take care. We came in this world, donate everything to Gurudev. We are well mentored or not? You can see here how we are happy and good. We are well mentored now. Sarvalabhar Paniyasa, Samyara Sadhu Bhaktanan, have to be always in good association. If you good association, then you can do bhajan. Otherwise, not at all. So how we know who is Guru? And why we go to Guru? We may think, oh, we can see in internet, so many books are available. Why you go to a mediator, a broker? Guru is not like a material mediator or broker. Without the cosmic knowledge of Gurudev, Krishna will not accept us. What you have to want to bhajan? Krishna told, have you any bona fide Guru? Devotee, no. Krishna told, Prathamam Guru Pujya Tatasneva Mamarchanam Tadisa Bhagavad Bhakti Jannatani Sparubhave. First, go to worship the Guru, take permission from him, then worship me. If you do so, it will work the other way, or it will go in vain. So, what is the symptom of Guru? Then, mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, Tasmar Guru Prapadreta, Jigdasa Sriyuktamam, Sathe Parita Nishnatam, Brahman Upasama Swayam. What is the symptom? Bhagavad study. Tasmar Guru Prapadreta. For this reason, we have to go to Guru. What is the reason? In this world, we are swept by threefold of miseries. If you want or not, you are bound to do that. Threefold miseries are, one is called adharmic, misery due to uncontrolled mind, adhidoidic, misery due to demigod, like sometimes dry, drought, sometimes snowstorm, sometimes flood, sometimes earthquake, happen due to demigods. We have been 3 days before we are Vancouver, they say, snowstorm, the demigods, and adi bhakti, the misery is caused by other living entity. So we want to get rid of these miseries, so we have to approach Krishna Gurudev. So what is symptom? It's two symptoms, one primary symptom and another secondary symptom. The primary symptom is the one, and secondary symptom divided into two. The primary symptom, it must be realized soul. How you know that? He realized soul or not? After go sadhu sangha. Goswami will tell, he is realized soul or not. By your own, idea to not judge him. And secondary symptom, sadhu nishnatam. Sadhu nishnatam means, he must be expert of Vedic scriptures. If devotee or disciple has any doubt, quoted from scripture, he can rule it out. This is one symptom. Second one, Upasthana Swayam must be detached from material world. This material world, Sankalpa 3W or 3N. You may ask, what is 3W, 3N? 3W means the main person they have done for 3W. Woman, oil, and wine. You can see the material world, this thinking they have done for this. Man for woman, oil, and wine. And 3W, 3N, for female, the hankering for men, money and marijuana. You must be judged from this 3W or 3N and must realize so. If you so, then if you surrender to him, then your life will be successful, return and happy. So we are so fortunate, in front of us, so Guru is present here. So please listen something for your listening, and if you do really bhajan and want to be eternally happy, please surrender to him. And by this kind of way, you do bhajan, you will be successful. There is no other way, no other way, no other way. Hare Krishna. Pancha Gautama Bhagavata Kishara 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 Kishara
Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Kishara Tasmai Sri Guruvya Mancha Kalpatarubhasya Kripasim Bhagyayimata Patitanam Pavane Vaisnavibhyo Namo Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurakhiche Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Vaitadadaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tada Bhaktaya Namo Tavai Vasmi Tavai Vasmi Nadimami Trayadina Iti Vigyay Radhe Tamnay Mama Charana First of all, by humble obeisances. In the lotus feet of my spiritual master, Nitya Lila Prabhisvamdi Sloka, Astota Sishmat Bhakti Pratyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. And same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Nitya Lila Prabhisvamdi Sloka, Astota Sishmat Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj, and Prakutyacharana Nitya Lila Prabhisvamdi Sloka Sishmat Madhav Goswami Maharaj. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told, after departure of Krishna from this world, Kali Yuga, iron age, at once came to this world. So all the rishis and maharshis from whole India, about 60,000, they came to Navisharana on the bank of a river Gomati. And this cousin, Kalinuri is coming. At that time, all ladies will give up their safety. They will divorce their husbands. Oh, not only 2, 3, 4, 10, but they will record me up to 20, 25. And also, men will give up their religious minded. They will also give up their, they will divorce their wives, and their son will not know that whom I am son. In the Kali Yuga, so much suffering will come, though so much advance of science will be. Like he told, aeroplanes will be, it will be discovered, like mind if we go, and a few hours we can go around the whole world. Also, now computer and other systems are discovered, that is, science has more developed. If anyone brain is gone, they can put another. If heart, they can put another heart. From kitchen room to all this, they have invented. But what became? They could not stop old age. They cannot stop our day. They are not invented. What is soul? That is, who are you? You should know that you are not this system. First, this body is a bag of urine, stool, blood and so on. If you open this, you will see nothing. Only this thing. So you are not this body, but you are soul, part and parcel of supreme law. You have forgotten, and that is why you are coming in the rotation of birth and death, birth and death. And you are enjoying for endless pain of endless birth and death. We want happiness, that really we cannot be happy. For this whole world, their delegation have made a Sanjukta Rashtra They want that whole world should be healthy. But how they can do anything? So, what they are thinking? They want to make this body healthy. But body, one day it will go away. What money you have collected at the time of death, you cannot take anything with you. Your relative, son, daughter, husband, anyone will not go with you. So, in Srimad Bhagavat, it has been told. They were discussing all. And in the meantime, Sukha Goswami, the disciple of Srila Sukadeva Goswami, appeared there. He came. They gave him Vyasasana and asked, "You are disciple of Sukadeva Goswami. You know Ved and Upanishad and everything from Parashara Rishi and others. You know everything. Please tell us how a soul will be held. Jayatma Samprasita. Tanve Bruhi. Jayatma Samprasita. A different ask that how body will be held. Because we knew that we are not ready. By happiness of the body, soul can be happy. By eating, drinking and smoking, it may be temporary, your body may be happy. But really no. Because you are not so. So what is the process that our soul may be happy forever? And consider gentle love and affection with me. Rishi. So, hearing this question, Sutta Goswami began thinking. He remembered all these three pastimes from Krishna. And he told, Savai Kumsan, Paro Dharmo, Yato Bhakti, Yato Kare, Ahed Tukra, Abdavakta, Jayatma, Sam Prashida. Parnalist wrote, the Rupa Goswami, very near and dear, Parkar of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has written, Anna Abhilashita Sunyam, Jnana Parmat Janatam, Ankulli Krishna Anusilamam Bhakti Uttama. You should explain what is meant.
Yanatilamasya dhananjana salakaya prakshur kundiritam yena tasmaye sri gurve namaha vancha kalpadrukyascha kripa sindhu devata patita nam pavane pyo vaishnave pyo namaha. First of all, I offer my humble obeisances on the Lord Lord Bhakti. Thousands of times unto the Lord's feet of my spiritual master, Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Parivrata Acharya Ashtapata Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. I offer my humble obeisances thousands of times unto all the Acharyas in the line of Sri Rupa Goswami. And also I offer my humble obeisances to all the Vaishnavas present, Kidami Sannyasis, senior Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis and all Kavgalas. And all that come here to hear Harikata from the Lord's lips of Srila Gurudev. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to speak on the definition of pure bhakti as it has been given by Srila Rupa Goswami. This definition is complete. Yeah? It is a very helpful for every sincere student, disciple who wants to progress in bhakti to remember what is the meaning of this particular shloka. Anya vilasita sunyam jnanakarmadi anavritam. Anupunyena krishna anusilanam bhaktir uttamam. Uttama bhakti, or the highest form of devotion, is that which is favorable for Sri Krishna, which brings happiness to Krishna, which is favorable for Krishna, and which is unbroken, uninterrupted, like a stream of honey. Not that we practice something, bhakti, for half an hour a day, and the rest of the day we do other things. This is something, but not complete, uttama, perfected bhakti. When we want to understand what is perfect, what is uttama, the highest form of bhakti, then 24 hours a day, as an unbroken chain, we are engaged in pure devotional services, which means favorable for Krishna, bringing pleasure to Krishna, uninterrupted, and under the guidance of Sadguru and pure Vaishnavas. Not only that, all our endeavors of mind, tongue, our words, our thoughts, our activities of our body, and the feelings, the moods which we have in our hearts should only be directed to bring pleasure to Krishna, to bring happiness to Krishna. So this will only be known if we are under guidance of Sadhu, Sadguru, and Vaishnavas who are advanced. So this is the definition of pure bhakti. Then, most important for those who are not familiar with the association of sadhus, who have not the opportunity to be always under guidance, that we understand what are the obstacles to attain pure bhakti. We are living here and there, not always having association. So it is described in the beginning two lines, Anya Adi Lasita Sunyam, Jnana Kalamani Anavrita, that we should not have any other desire but the desire only to bring happiness and pleasure to Krishna. If we have so many desires to make this body happy, to make our family happy, to be well known in society, that everybody likes me, these things are not favorable for pure bhakti. We should try to have only one desire, and that is how to bring happiness to Krishna. So if our desires, if our intentions are covered with all these other desires, then pure bhakti is far away from us. Second line, jnana karmani anarthika. It should not be covered by any activities, karma. It should not be covered by any endeavors to obtain knowledge, especially the knowledge that we are one with Krishna, that we are all Brahm, we are all spirit. This is very, very detrimental and very dangerous of pure bhakti. However, we cannot live without doing activities. We cannot live without having some information, gathering good knowledge. So that knowledge which is favorable, which is not covering our bhakti, that can be cultivated. And those activities which are not covering our activities to perform bhakti, that can be accepted. We can have a job, we can cook, we can chant, meditate, we can look after each other, as long as these things are not covering our desire to perform bhakti. As long as they are beneficial, nourishing our bhakti, we can perform these activities. Not that we work, as Srimad Bhagavatam explained, only to get the money, money, money. But we are working to earn some money and just enough to keep body and soul together and spend the balance of our time to be in sadhu sangha, to practice the activities of uttama bhakti, shravanam, kirtanam, vishnu swaranam, Archinam Bandaram Dashkap Satyam Atman Hedaram. Those activities are described as the activities of Swarup Siddha Bhakti. Those activities which form the very Swarup of Uttama Bhakti. Not that we are engaged in Aroka Siddha Bhakti. We think that we are doing this for Krishna, working day and night, earning money, but have no time to hear. When sadhu comes, we have no time to hear because we have to earn money for Krishna. Or we are so busy that we have no time even to invite sadhus. Or to chant or remember or read, we should be very careful that our bhakti doesn't become covert. That we can properly engage 24 hours a day gradually. It may be that at present we can do this for 2 hours or 3 hours or 1 hour or half an hour. No harm, but we can increase gradually if we always remember that this is the barometer of our bhakti. Every evening we can think, remember how much today I was engaged in uninterrupted devotional services. And how much I will do tomorrow, like an expert businessman. He will think how much profit I have gathered today. Tomorrow I will try to earn more. So our bhakti should be like that. But every day we consider, what did I do today in order to serve Vaishnavas, to please Sri Guru, because this is our life and soul. We may say, okay, Anyavidasna Sunyam Karmani Navitam Anukulya Krishna Anushivanam. I will please Krishna, I will make Krishna happy. But who is Krishna? This is the first lesson when we take a serious interest in the process of bhakti. Krishna is Ashray Bhagavan and Vishay Bhagavan. We don't have any eyes to see Krishna. We think, oh, this is Krishna, I have a beautiful murti of Krishna. But we have no capacity to interact with Krishna because our senses are completely covered by the material energy. But Krishna is so kind. He provides his pure representative, sends them to this world, that please you go around and wake up everyone. You are the eternal servant of Krishna. You don't belong in this world. You're supposed to be very happy. Always engaged in activities to benefit others. Especially to benefit Sri Krishna. When will you come and join me in the spiritual world? Krishna is telling this in scripture, but we cannot hear and understand unless somebody says, come on, I will bring you to a pure devotee, a pure representative of Krishna. And that is called Ashraya Bhagavan. So Anyavilasita Sunyam, if we apply this to Guru first, then we can very quickly make advancement. How can I please Gurudev? How can I do that which is favorable for Gurudev? Assist him in one way or another. Then, very quickly, our bhakti will progress. So all of us have this opportunity to see every day. What did I do today? No harm if you need half an hour. Tomorrow, increase. Gradually, gradually increase more and more. Invite sadhus, hear from them. And in this way, increase your understanding of the process of pure bhakti. And every day you will see that your life becomes more and more full of happiness, which we are all hankering for. As we have heard, happiness is not in this world. How many lifetimes do we try to enjoy sense gratification? Thousands and thousands of lifetimes. And never have we achieved it. We are still hankering for sense gratification. But Krishna is telling, not in this life, in this human life, I have given you the opportunity to engage in devotional services. And by this you will be happy forever. Not only that, you will leave this cycle of birth and death and be with me forever. So don't misuse, as Sukha Maharaj has so nicely presented, from young age we should engage in bhakti yoga. So Srila Rupa Goswami Pada has given us this complete definition. Take it with us and cherish this, and every day check how much we have advanced and our life will become successful. Apply this to Sri Guru, apply this to Vaishnavas, so that we can always have that kind of opportunity to engage in the activities of pure bhakti.
In this definition, briefly we can tell the activity of body, mind and mind. And about this, how we can move. If it is done for to please Krishna, then it is bhakti. Whether Krishna will meet him or he is not happy here, then it means that this is not pure devotion or bhakti. For example, I will clarify that in the arena of Kamsa, Krishna entered with the teeth of elephant, some drop of blood was in their head, Krishna and Baladeva. Entered, then Charu was taken. Oh, they were ready to fight with Krishna. And they challenged Krishna and Baladeva. But Krishna told her, like a baby boy, and you are so like mountain. How can I fight with you? Oh, I can wrestle from those who are equal to me in age. Then they told you, you have killed Arhasur, Bakasur, Kukana. You are not a small child. And telling, and they catch hold of the hand of Krishna and they brought them in arena and they began to fight to kill Krishna. Krishna was very happy that today I am enjoying this rush. But though Krishna is happy, but this is not bhakti. Pratikulena, not anukulena. They want to make Krishna, they wanted to kill Krishna. So this is not bhakti. And in other way, Madhav Yashoda, you know that she bided Krishna in charted mortar. Krishna became very angry and he was beating. This beating is it a Uttama Bhakti? Krishna is beating here. Mother, don't bind me. Don't beat me. I am weeping. Tears coming. Oh yes, it is beautiful. Because Yashoda mother is chastising, though he may be Param Brahma, Supreme Lord. But I am his mother. He should not be spoiled. So I will chastise him. So this is pure bhakti. For Krishna. I'm giving an example to more clarify what is Uttama Bhakti. You know that Maharaj Dasarath in Treta Yuga, to please his wife Kaikeyi, to fulfill his two bones, that Ramchandra should be exiled for 14 years and Bhat should be king of Ayodhya. Ram went to exile. And then Bharat, Sita and Lakshman also followed him. person so good to have long hair, they have at the home of his material control. Maharaj Dasarath, he told Ram, Haram, and left his birth. He died. When Bhakt and Satrughna returned back to Ajudhya, they saw that Ajudhya is like a widow woman. No one is coming to him. All are hating. What is the thing? Why they are hating me? They don't want to speak with me. Then he went to her mother and asked, oh, why all are sad here? Then she told, I took two bones from Maharaj Dasarath and he fulfilled my desire. So Ramchandra has been sent to exile and Bharata's Lakshman and Sita have done with him. And Maharaj Dasarath, oh, could not there is the separation of Ram, Haram, Haram, and her told, oh, if you are not your new mother, I will kill you. But now I have no relation with you. And then he called Maharaj Vasti, Vasishtha and all other rich persons of wealthy persons of Ajodhya, and he went to Chitrakoot to meet his brother and to tell him that you should return back and be the king of Ajodhya. Three mothers also went there. Whole military also went there. And the paraphernalia of Abhishek for Ramchandra also it was taken. When they reached there in the night, Bhakt took rest with whole party and mother. In the night he went to Mother Kaushindya and he told Mother Kaushindya, there is my request that you, if you will tell Ram to return back to Ajodhya and to be king, he cannot refuse. He must. You should tell him. He told, how can I tell you? Because am I wrong? No, you are not wrong. You are ocean of love and affection. But Ram, like him always, in Dharma. So he can dive in your love and affection ocean, but he will not move an inch here and there. So how can I? Then he went to Vasishtha Maharaj, Gurudev. He told same thing, and he answered same thing. And then he returned back. Then, at that time, Maharaj Janak, the father of Sita Devi, he was there, he came there. A big council was there. One side, Sri Ramchandra, Lakshman, Sita, and other side, Ajodhya, the inhabitants of Ajodhya, all were sitting. And one side, all the rishis and maharshis were there. And in the middle, Maharaj Janak was there, speaking. Maharaj Vasishtha told, you know that after the death of Maharaj Dasarath, the nauka, boat of Ajodhya is about to be. So, You have reached here. You are their guru and father, like father also. You should save the Ajodhya. Then Maharajana short words, Sri Ramachandra. Will you obey my order? What I will decide? Shorten, because you are like my father and also my guru. And then he short towards her and asked, will you obey me? Oh, Shorten, I must obey. Then he told, he meditated, Bhagavan Shanta, his Gurudev. And then he began to tell. Here, the love of perfection of Bharat. Bharat has owned, and Ramchandra is defeated. So, but all thought that, oh, if Bharat is owned, then he will go to Ajodhya to take the position of king. But in the meantime, Maharaj Janak told, though you have won and Sri Ramchandra is defeated, but yet love and affection, Prem has his own riti niti, rules and regulations. You should go to Ram. He told yesterday and asked me how he will be pleased and do according to that. Then Bharata stood up and fell on the feet of Maharaj Janak that you are Guru. Up till now I was thinking that if Ram will go, I will be in his head. All inhabitants of Ajodhya will be happy, Bhagavas will be happy. But I never thought that how Ram will be pleased. Now I think. And he went and did pranam to Ram and asked, my dear brother, how you will be happy? I will follow your order. Then Ramchandra told, oh, as Maharaj Janak has told, I am defeated, so really I am defeated. Now I am taking the kingdom of Ajodhya and out I am king. But I want that father promise also be fulfilled. So for 14 years you like my representative, you should return back to Ajodhya. And from like my representative, you should look after kingdom. Then Bhar took his sandal on his way and returned. So our happiness is not bhakti, pure bhakti. Like Maharaj Yuga, in 6 months only, he meditated on Narayan. And after that he took darshan of Narayan. But what Narayan gave him for the 6,000 years, he will be king of whole universe. So his bhakti is not true. So we should have no worldly desire. We should have desire to fulfill the desire of Krishna. This is pure. By the gradation of this bhakti, Srila Sanatana Goswami had told there are 5 kinds of devotee. Jnani bhakti. Then Shuddha bhakti. Then pure bhakta, then primatum bhakta, prepra bhakta, and primatum bhakta. Prahlad Maharaj is jnani bhakta. He was not jnani, but jnani bhakta. Those who think that I am Brahmasmi, I am handsome Brahmasmi. All are Brahma. Pragyanam Brahma. Tattam Asi Soham. That is Akesh Bhakti. So, we should not follow this. But here, Jnani Bhakta means he always used to see everywhere his Ishtadev, Krishna. And everyone heart is good to see his Ishtadev. And in Ishtadev is good to see all living entity. That is Jnani Bhakta. Prahlad Maharaj, he knew that he is Supreme Lord. He has no lust or appetite. He cannot feed him. He never become tired. He cannot message. He cannot do any serving. But by all the senses we should serve, so he is called Jnanipa. He cannot do any personal service to Supreme Lord. And then, you know, Ambarish Maharaj, by 11 senses, he used to serve Krishna. And his kingdom ruled by Dhanesh. And then, more superior, Premi Bhakta Hanuman, always serving day and night. But he cannot give his remnant to Ramchandra, Supreme Lord. He cannot embrace Ramchandra. Most superior, Pandav, always used to eat in one plate, sleeping on the same bed. In this way, Krishna has given marriage to her, his sister, Subhadra. In Mahabharata battle, he became charioteer and he followed the order of Arjuna. Oh, take thy chariot in the middle of both armies. He did. But when he saw his Swarup, less hands, so many mouths, everything, and he saw that all both armies in the teeth of about to die. Then he began to tell, I have done wrong, offensive. I have told you, Sapa, I have ordered you. You better my chariot. From now I will let you. Please excuse me. More than that, Uddhav, his Sakha, his
minister,
Prime Minister, and so many things. Sakha, Commander in Chief, everything was. But he also cannot give his remnant to Krishna. He takes him like his Supreme Master. And he forgives his prayer, seeing the high class of devotion of Gopi. Asa Maho, Charan Rai, Nisam Aham Syam, Vrindavane, Kimam Gurmano Bhavsadina. Thus, those Pajamaswajana Arya Patanche Hitva, Hede Mukhanda Padane, Sotati Vrindavane. Still now, the Sutis, the Vedas, they are searching Krishna, but still not they have taken us. But Gopis have kept Krishna in their hand. So I want to be in braid of cross in Vrindavan. And there gopis will come and their foot dust will my way and my life will be successful. Bande nanda prajeshtvina pavarenu apikshnane jasan bharitvapo bhi nātvara. I am praying the dust of any gopis. One dust. So one dust from who? O Bandi Radha. Because in separation group, they have told so many Hari Katha, Bhramar Deep, Gopi Deep and Venu Deep, so many things. Their love and affection is unparalleled. So Krishna has himself told, Napare Ham Nirvatya Sanjuna, O Gopis, I cannot see you in having a life of Brahma. I can. But you are sadhu yourself. You can excuse me and repay me, but I will always always get it to you. And among them, Paradika, Anayaradiko Mundam Bhamam Hari Vishwara, Jagno Bihaya Govinda, Jan As. Here he is telling that, oh, Radhika, this lady who has done with Krishna in Nirjal Pradesh, in solitary place, she is most dear to Krishna because Krishna has taken alone her as her. So Srimati Radhika is supreme lover of Krishna, most beloved of Krishna. So in this life, we must have a goal. Without goal, life of goal, we are like animals. The first step should be goal, to be the best servant of such a Radhika. Then we can have some love and affection for Radha and Krishna Guru. This is aim and object of our bhajan, our life. And what is the process to attain? Then, ādhav sattha, tato sādhav sattha, tato bhajan kriya, tato anarthana bhakti, tato nishtha, bhuti, then asakti, then bhav and aim. Beginning from here. And for this, you will have to do upadeshamrita, follow upadeshamrita. The nectar of Śrīla Rūpa Gosvāmī. All upadesh. So, in briefly, I have told you, your life should be successful. You should try to make your aim and objective of life there and can follow practicing. Gau Premānde.
Jaja Radha Ramana Hari Gau.